Hi guys, my name is Shachi and welcome to my channel. This channel is all about productivity, fitness and lifestyle. Wish you all a very happy 2018 and welcome to the first sit down video of this year. I'm recording this video pretty early in the morning and Bangalore has just been so cold this year, which is the reason why I'm all wrapped up and cozy in this red thing. One of the best ways to welcome the new year for me is by cleaning up my house. Basically, what that means is by decluttering and downsizing my possessions, especially the things which I don't have in use anymore. I did try my hand at minimalism in 2017 with a few baby steps and loved the way it made me feel. So I definitely want more of that in 2018. So in this video, I have put together a 10-day step-by-step guide to minimalism. Now these cover different categories and each category has different items in it. So feel free to go about it in whichever order you want and at a pace that you are comfortable with. At the end of the 10 days, I guarantee you, you will feel great and love the space around you. So let's dive right into the video. And before we begin, I would just like to say that if you feel that this is a video which is going to help you out and add value to your day, then please show your support by hitting that subscribe button. So let's start with the first category, that's personal belongings. Day one is for our bags and wallets. Isn't it annoying when we have to keep digging into a bag to find what we are looking for? So take this day to clear out your bags and wallets. I caught hold of my wallet and cleared out old receipts, broken cards, expired credit cards, and a bunch of other things which I had no use anymore. You can do the same and then even move on to your handbags and clear them out. Day two is for our clothes and our shoes. Now I understand that it's a big category and it might take you more than one day. That's completely okay. The idea is to go through our wardrobe and collect the clothes and shoes which we haven't worn in a year. Because let's be honest, if there's something which you haven't worn in a year, it's unlikely that you're ever going to use it again. So collect all these things and drop them off at a donation center near your house. Day three is for your beauty products and this includes your hair, skincare, makeup and perfumes. These are the things which somehow just get accumulated over time. Go through your collection and put aside everything which you don't use anymore because it's not your style anymore, which has expired or you haven't duplicated. I found that I was holding on to way too many lip balms and this was one of the things that I had to clear off. That completes category one and now let's move on to the next category, that is our home. Day four is for your kitchen supplies. So take this day to go through your kitchen shelves and cabinets. And I'm sure that you'll find things which are broken, which are unused, or you simply didn't know that you have. So take this day to clear out all of this. I found that I was hanging on to way too many plastic containers. Some of them were even broken, so I had to clear them off. Day five is for home decor and furniture. I used to love buying decor pieces and knickknacks, but I don't do that anymore, simply because I felt that it just added clutter and occupied so much more space. So take this day to go through your home decor pieces and you will find things which are tacky, which are broken and things which are simply not your style and do not bring you that same joy anymore. So this is the day to put them aside and clear them off. You can also take this day to go through your furniture and if you find that you're holding on to old pieces of furniture which are broken and not in use anymore, then this is the day to let them go. Day six is for your food products. Take this day to go through your fridge and your pantry and collect those food products which are old, rotting, expired and which you know that you're not going to eat. Many times we buy food products but we end up not eating it and it just sits in our shelves crowding it. So take day six to clean it up. Day seven is for your junk drawer. We all have that one drawer or shelf in our house where things which do not have any specific use or place end up getting dumped and this drawer can be a mess. So when I cleared out my junk drawer, it was actually pretty amusing because the things that came out of there, most of them I had no memory of putting it in there and I had no clue that they even existed in my house. And now let's move on to the third category, that's miscellaneous. And day eight is for your books and your documents. So go through your book collection on day eight. Now I'm all for keeping books which are dear to you and which hold value to you. But there are some books which you read once and you're never going to go back to it. So day eight is for clearing out those books, collecting them and passing it on to someone else who might find it useful. You can also use this day to clear out your documents. And this was one of the biggest challenges for me because I always end up with a pile of unsorted documents. So take day eight to go through your document piles, categorize them into different categories and get rid of the documents which are no longer useful. Day 9 is for digital detox, and I think this is something which we should do more often. So on day 9, catch hold of your mobile phones, laptops, iPads, and clear out old photos, files, and any other junk which is just occupying all that memory space and not useful. What you could also do is take one step further and get rid of annoying WhatsApp groups, unsubscribe from email lists, and basically clear out anything which is just adding to the digital junk and not helping you anymore. And lastly, we come to day 10, and this is my favorite. Day 10 is for you. You have gone through 9 days of decluttering and organizing, and you're about to begin a whole new year. So take this day for yourself. Do something relaxing. It could be journaling, meditating, going for a long walk, catching up with a friend. Basically anything which will help you declutter your mind and feel more centered and relaxed, so that you begin the new year with a clear mindset and a clear vision of everything that you want to do. So that's it, guys. These were the 10 days of minimalism, and these cover just the basics. So if you're in the flow, feel free to add more days and add more categories to this list. I also have a printable guideline checklist for you in the description box below. This will basically help you go through these 10 days in a more organized manner. So feel free to check it out and print your copy. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this video has helped you out. If it did, show your support by giving it a thumbs up and hitting that subscribe button. Wish you a very happy new year. I'll see you next week. Signing off for now. Bye.